Good morning, student. Today, I am Manju Subba from Kana Kingdom Smart Education, and I am going to teach you mathematics of third class. And the topic is subtraction. Okay, dear student. Now, today we are going to learn about subtraction. Today we are going to learn about subtraction of three-digit numbers without and with regrouping. Subtraction of four-digit number without and with regrouping. Properties of subtraction. We are going to learn about all these things in today's class. Now we are going to learn about subtraction. Subtraction means to take out one amount from another. Subtraction means to take out one amount from another. Subtraction means to take it is, or subtraction is a process by which you can take out some amount from other big amount. Like subtraction can be done in big quantities or in big number, because from big quantities we can subtract something from them. Okay, student. And the terms minuend, the terms minuend, subtrahend, the terms minuend, subtrahend, and difference are used while subtraction. In the process of subtraction, we use minuend, subtrahend, and difference. Wait. First, I would like to clear you what is minuend. First, I would like to clear you what is minuend. Okay. Now, dear student, minuend means a number from which another number is to be subtract. So, minuend is a number or quantity from which another number or quantity is to be subtracted. Like in this example, see. Everyone look at this screen. Look, 59 minus 36, right? 59 minus 23. 59 minus 23 is equal to 36. But in this subtraction, 59 is minuend. So 59 is minuend because 59 is a number from which the number 23 is subtracted, right? So minuend is a number from which another number can be or is to be subtracted. Okay, student. Then subtrahend is a number to be subtracted from another. Subtracted is a number to be subtracted from another. That means, see, in this subtraction, 59 minus 23 is equal to 36. 23 is a number which is subtracted from 59, where 59 is minuend and 23 is subtrahend. So subtrahend is a number which to be subtracted from another. Okay, student. 23. That means in this subtraction, 23 is subtrahend and 59 is minuend. And 36 is a difference. 36 is a difference, because difference means a quantity or number which amount. By which amount differ. The remainder left after subtraction of one value from another is called subtraction. Subtraction means a number or quantity by which amounts differ. The remainder left after subtraction subtraction. The remainder left after subtraction of one number from another is called difference. Got it? Difference means a number or quantity by which amount differ. The remainder left after subtraction of one number or one value from another is called subtraction. Okay, student? Difference means by which the amounts differ. The remainder after left subtraction of one value from another. See, 59 minus 23 is equal to 36. Where 36 is difference, because 36 is a remainder left after subtracting 23 from 59 is, so the difference means the remainder left after subtraction of two number. Like in this subtraction, 36 is a remainder. 36 is a remainder left after subtracting 23 from 59. So 36 is different. Wait, 59 is minute, because 59 is a number from which another number, that is 23, is subtracted, right? And 23 is subtrahend, because 23 is a number to be subtracted from another. So 23 is subtracted from 59. So 23 is subtrahend and 59 is minute and 36 is difference. So see, in subtraction there is three main terms, that is minuend, subtrahend and difference. Okay, now we are going to learn about subtraction of three-digit number without regrouping. Subtraction of three-digit number without regrouping. So let us solve one example. That is, subtract 104 from 427. So in this example, we have to subtract 104 from 427. So the solution of subtraction of three-digit number without regrouping, the step one is subtract the one in the number four. In while subtracting 104 from 427, 427 is minuend is the number from which we have to subtract number, right? Minuend is a number from which we have to subtract number, right? So while subtracting 104 from 207, 104 is subtrahend, right? Subtrahend is 104 is subtrahend. In this subtraction, 427 is minuend and 104 is subtract. So let's subtract the ones. The first step is subtract the ones. So from minuend, subtract the ones. So from minuend, 7 is a digit which is present in ones place, right? Ones place. So ones place, in ones place 7 is present, right? So in another number, that is subtrahend, 4 is a digit which is present in ones place. So we have to subtract 4 from 7. So while subtracting 4 from 7, we get 3 as a difference, right? 3 as a difference. So write 3 in a ones column. So write 3 in a ones column, because we get 3 as a difference of subtracting the ones, right? So the step two, subtract the tens. We have to subtract the tens. So in the number 427. 2 is a digit which is present in tens place, right? 2 is a digit which is present in ones place, and in the number 104. 0 is a digit which is present in tens place, which is present in tens place. So while subtracting 0 from 2, we get 2 as a difference, right? So write 2 in the tens column. So write 2 in a tens column. So step 3, subtract the 100. We have to subtract the 100. So while subtracting the 100, in the number 427, 4 is a digit which is present in 100 place, and in the number 104, 1 is a number which is present in 100 place, right? So 1 is a digit which is present in 100 place. So subtract the 100. That means we have to subtract 1 from 4, right? We have to subtract 1 from 4. So while subtracting 1 from 4, we get 3 as a difference. We get 3 as a difference. So write 3 in a 100 column. So thus, while subtracting 104 from 427, while subtracting 104 from 427, we got 323 as a difference of 427 and 104. Okay, so let's revise shortly. The subtraction of 3-digit number without regrouping. Step 1. Step 1 is subtract the ones. We have to subtract the ones. That means we have to subtract the digit which are present in ones place. Okay, now the second is subtract the tens. We have to subtract the digit which are present in tens place in both number. In both number means in minuend and in subtrahend. Okay, and the step 3 is subtract the 100. Subtract the 100. Step 3 is subtract the 100. While subtract the 100. So this is a process, or this is a step of subtraction of 3-digit number without regrouping. Okay, student, I hope you all have understood through this example. So now we are going to learn about subtraction of 3-digit number. Subtraction of 3-digit number with regrouping. Right, just before we learn subtraction of 3-digit number without regrouping, now we are going to learn with regrouping. Subtraction of 3-digit number with regrouping. Okay, for this we are taking one example, that is subtract 348 from 577. Subtraction, we are going to subtract 348 from 557. First we'll make a place value chart. Okay, see, like same as in screen. See, first I make the place value chart, that is ones, tens and thousand. I put the digit of that two number here, and from subtract 348 from 577. From here we can easily understand that 557 is minuend, right? And 340 is subtract. So at first we'll write the big number, that is 557, because it is minuend na. So in second line we'll place the digit of subtract, that is 348. Okay, the first step of subtraction of 3-digit number with regrouping. The first step is subtract the ones. The first step is subtract the ones. Subtract the ones. So in the number 557, 7 is the digit. 7 is the digit which is place, or which is in ones place, right? Which is in ones place. So we have to subtract 8 from 7. Is this possible to subtract 8 from 7? Is this possible? Just tell me, is this possible to subtract 8 from 7? No, right? Because 7 is smaller than 8. Sorry, 7 is smaller than 8, yes. So we cannot subtract 8 from 7. So for this, in number 557, we have to borrow. Now for the subtraction of the ones, to complete the step 1, we have to borrow 1 10 from the tens in ones column. In one column, see, in ones place, 7 is smaller than, so we cannot subtract 8 from 7. So 7 will borrow 1 10 from the tens column. That means in tens column there is 7. So in tens column there is 7. So 7 is in tens column. It means 7 10. That means 70, right? So in ones column, the digit in ones column, that is also 7, right? So 7 is asking or borrowing 1 10 from the digit which is present in tens place. So in tens place 7 is there. So 7, the digit 7 of ones place will borrow 1 10 from the 7 which is in tens place. So what the 7, the ones, so will borrow 1 10 from the tens column and regroup. So 1 10, we are borrowing 1 10. That means 1 0 10. That means 1 10 means 10, right? So we are borrowing 1 10. That means tens from the tens column to the ones. So tens plus 1 10 plus 7, because 7 ones, so which is equals to 17, right? So in ones column there is 17 in ones column. So is this possible to subtract 8 from 17? Possible? Is this possible or not? Yes, it is possible, because 17 is greater than 8. So we will subtract 8 from 17. So 8 from 17, it means we are subtracting 8 from 17, we will get 9 as a difference, right? 9 as a difference. So write 9 in a ones column, because while subtracting the ones, we got 9 as a difference. So step 1, we complete step 1. So we'll start step 2, that is subtract the tens. The step 2 is subtract the tens. So in while subtracting is in tens place, in tens place, right? In tens place, in tens place, in the number of the number 577, there is 6, right? How 6? Because since 1 10 was already borrowed by ones column, right? Already borrowed, because in first step we borrow 1 10 from the tens column to the ones. So since 1 10 was borrowed by ones column, so therefore there is 6. So we have to subtract 4 from 6. So in second step, that is subtract the tens, there is 6. So we have to subtract 4 from 6. So while subtracting 4 from 6, we get 2 as a difference, right? 2 as a difference. So while subtracting the tens, we got 2 as a difference. So write 2 in a tens column, right? 2 in a tens column. So while subtracting 4 from 6, we got 2 as a difference. So write 2 in a tens column, right? 2 in a tens column. So we completed the second step. So in third step, that is subtract the 100. So we have to subtract the 100 in first number, that is 577. 5 is a digit which is present in 100 place. So we have to subtract the 3 from 6 from 5. Sorry, 3 from 5, because 3 is a digit which is present in 100 planes of subtract, right? So we have to subtract 3 from 5. So while subtracting the hundreds or the subtracting 3 from 5, we get 2 as a difference, right? 2 as a difference. So while subtracting the 100, we got 2 as a difference. So we have to write 2 in a 100 column. So thus 577 while subtracting 348 from 557, we got 229 as a difference. 229 as a difference. So subtraction of 3 digit number without regrouping, the first step is subtract the ones. If the digit of bigger number is smaller than the subtrahend, the digit of subtrahend, then we have to borrow from tens column 1, 10. We have to borrow 1, 10 from the tens column. So from that we can easily subtract, right? So the first step is subtract the ones, and the second step is subtract the tens. And after subtracting the tens, we have to subtract the hundreds. So in this way, we subtract the 3-digit number without regrouping. So I hope you all have understood subtraction of 3-digit number without regrouping through this example. Now we are going to learn about subtraction of 4-digit numbers without regrouping. Subtraction of 4-digit number without regrouping. Okay. Subtract 3,226 from 5,438. We are going to subtract 3,226 from 5,438. Let's start. Step 1. The step 1 of the first step of subtraction of 4-digit number without regrouping is subtract the ones. We have to subtract the ones. So in the number 5,438, 8 is a digit which is present in ones place. So we have to subtract 6 from 8, right? Because 6 is a digit which is present in ones place of the number 3,226, right? So we have to subtract 6 from 8. So while subtracting 6 from 8, we get 2 as a difference, right? We got 2 as a difference. So write 2 in ones column. So we have to write 2 in ones column. And the second step of subtraction of 4 digit number without regrouping is, the second step is subtract the tens. We have to subtract the tens. That means we have to subtract the digit which are present in tens place. So in the number 5,438, 3 is the digit which is present in tens place, right? So we have to now from 3,226, 2 is the digit which is present in tens place. So we have to subtract 2 from 3. So while subtracting 2 from 3, we get 1 as a difference, right? So we have to 1 as a difference. So while subtracting 2 from 3, we got 1 as a difference. So write 1 in a tens column. And the third step is subtract the hundreds. Now we are going to subtract the hundreds. So it means we have to subtract the hundreds, right? Subtract the hundreds. So in the number 5,438, 4 is a digit which is present in 100 place, right? And in the number 3,226, 2 is a digit which is present in 100 place. So we have to subtract 2 from 4. So while subtracting 2 from 4, we get 2 as a difference, right? So we got 2 as a difference. So write 2 in a 100 column. So the fourth step is subtract the 1000. So we have to subtract the 1000. So in the number 5438, 5 is a digit which is present in 1000 column. And in the number 3226, 3 is a digit which is present in 1000 columns. So we have to subtract 3 from 5. So while subtracting 3 from 5, we get 2 as a difference. So while subtracting 3 from 5, we got 2 as a difference. So we have to write 2 in a 1000 columns. So while subtracting 3226 from 5438, we got 2212 as a difference. So this is a process, or this is a step, or this is a method of subtraction of 4-digit number without regrouping. So the first step is subtract the ones, and the second step is subtract the tens, and the third step is subtract the 100, and the fourth step is subtract the 1000. So in this way we have to subtract, or we have to solve 4-digit number, subtraction of 4-digit number without regrouping. Okay student, so I hope you all have understood through this example. Okay, now we are going to learn about subtraction of 4-digit number with regrouping. Right? So we already learned subtraction of 4-digit number without regrouping. So now we are going to learn about subtraction of 4-digit number with regrouping. Okay, student. Now, so let us one example, that is subtract 2416 from 6332. Let's subtract 2416 from 6325. Okay student, now let's subtract the step one. The step one of subtraction of 4-digit number with regrouping. First, make a place value chart up to 1000 and place the number in place value chart. Okay student, you all know that in this two number, the 2466 is subtracted and minuend is 6325. So you have to write 6000, you have to place the number 6325 in the first column. In the second column you have to write or place 2416. Okay student, now let's subtract. Okay, since first step is subtract the ones, so we have to subtract 6 from 5. So it is not possible because we all know that 5 is less than 6, right? Because 5 is less than 6. So since 6 is greater than 5, so we have to borrow in the same way like we borrow in subtraction of 3-digit number with regrouping. In the same way we have to borrow 110 from the tens column. And regroup the ones. Then we have to regroup the ones. Like we are borrowing 110. That means 10 plus in ones column there is already 5. So you have to add 10 plus 5. So 15 ones. So it is possible to subtract 6 from 15, right? So while subtracting 6 from 15, we get 9 as a difference, right? So we got 9 as a difference while subtracting the 1. So write 9 in a ones column, then will move towards the second step, that is subtract the tens. The second step is subtract the tens. Since 110 was borrow, since 110 was already borrow, so 110 is left in the column, right? 110 is left in the column. So 1 minus 1 or 110 minus 110 equals to 0, right? So while subtracting 1 from 1, we got 0 as a difference. So write 0 in a tens column, because already 1, since 110 was already borrowed by 1's column, so 110 is left in that column. So while subtracting 110 from 110, we got 0 as a difference. So write 0 in a tens column. Okay, and after second step, that is there is third step or step 3, that is subtract the 100. We have to subtract the 100. Since see 4 is greater than 3, right? So we can't subtract 4 from 3 because 4 is greater than 3. So since 4 is greater than 3, borrow 1000 from the 1000 column. So you have to borrow 1000 from the 1000 column. Well, 1000 to the we have to borrow from 1000 column. So we have to borrow 1000 from the 1000 column. So in 100 column there is 3. So while borrowing 1000 from the 1000 column, we have 13000, right? We have 13000. So we can easily subtract 400 from 1300. So 13 minus 4, or we can easily subtract 4 from 13. So while subtracting 4 from 13, we got 9 as a difference. So 9 as a difference. So while subtracting the 100 columns, we got 9 as a difference. So we have to write 9 in a 100 column. Okay student, we have to write 9 in a 100 column. Okay, now after completing third step, we have to move towards step 4, that is subtract the 1000. We have to subtract the 1000 column. Or see, in 1000 column 100 is already 1000 is already given 1000 to the 100 column, right? In third step, so there is only 5000. So we have to subtract. Since 1000 was borrowed by the 1000 column, 5000 was left here, so we have to subtract 2000 from 5000. So while subtracting this 2 from 5, we got 3 as a difference, right? While subtracting 2 from 5, we got 3 as a difference. So thus subtraction, while subtracting 2416 from 6325, we got 3909 as a difference. We got 3909 as a difference. So this is a process, or this is a method by which we can subtract 4-digit number with regrouping. Okay dear student, I hope you all have understood subtraction of 4-digit number with regrouping through this example. Okay student, now after learning subtraction of 4-digit number without and with regrouping, now solve the following. I'll give you 2 minutes time to copy this question from the screen. So please copy this question and solve this question by yourself. Okay student. Now we are going to learn about properties of subtraction. Properties of subtraction. Okay. Now we will see that what properties of subtraction. When we subtract 0 from any number, we always get the number itself. While subtracting 0 from any number, we always get. That means we always get the number itself. That means when we subtract 0 from a number, like when we subtract 0 from 100, the answer will be 100, right? So the number, we always get the number itself. That means we always get the difference, the number itself. Okay, student, in the same way, like for example, 346 minus 0. While subtracting 0 from 346, we get 346, its answer itself, right? So the number itself. So it means when we subtract 0 from any number, we always get the number itself. Okay, student, now when we subtract, now the second property is when we subtract 1 from any number. When we subtract 1 from any number, we get the number just before the given number. We get the answer or number just before the given number. For example, when you subtract 1 from 100, you will get 99, right? 99 as a difference or 99 as a answer. So it's easily what it means, we get the number just before the given number. That means we get, while subtracting 1 from any number, we get the number just before the given number, right? Okay. For example, 655 minus 1. While subtracting 1 from 655, we get 655 as a difference. 655 as a difference. So it means we got the number just before the 655, right? So while subtracting, when we subtract 1 from any number, we get the number just before the given number. Okay, now the second and the third properties of subtraction is when we subtract a number from itself, we always get 0. When we subtract a number from itself, that means if we subtract the number from itself, we always get 0. For example, if you subtract 100 from 100, we will get 0, right? So in the same way, for example, 212 minus 212 equals to, while subtracting 212 from 212, we got 0 as a sum. So it means when we subtract a number from itself, we always get 0. Okay. The properties of subtraction. The properties of subtraction. When we subtract 0 from any number, we always get the number itself. When we subtract 1 from any number, we get the number just before the given number. When we subtract a number from itself, we always get 0. Okay, student, this is the properties of subtraction. I hope you all have understood this class nicely. Okay.